we are able to think? How can we talk with the clarity and fluency? Any guess? This is because nerve cells inside our body are playing their role. These are none other than neurons. Welcome back, friends. Welcome to another video of Sapien Blog. In this video, we'll talk about neuron and its structure. Our nervous system guides us to think, to respond to the various stimuli around us. So here, neurons are playing their role. We can say that these are structural and functional unit of our nervous system. So this is a system which guides us to do our daily things that we are carrying out on daily basis. So neurons, they are basically comprising of cyton and axon. So let's see their structure in detail. First, we'll talk about cyton. Cyton, it is a part that contains cytoplasm. And this structure is known as neuroplasm. This cyton is having all the cell organelles such as nucleus, mitochondria, Golgi, that aids in packaging, especially ER or endoplasmic reticulum, ribosome, and fat granule. This fat granule is also known as Nissl's granule. So now let's have a look on the structure, how we can prepare the structure of neuron. It is star-shaped cyton, which is attached to the long tubular axon. So the structure somewhat look like that. So what you need to do, first you need to make a star-like structure. Like that. And then you need to create a branches. Just like that, you need to do. So these branches are nothing but dendrites. So they are involved in carrying signal from one part of the body to another part. So the structure is very simple and easy to make. As you can see here. So this part is known as cyton. In this, you will see the central nucleus, here some fibril-like structures are there, and we can say that these are neurofibrils. These are branches-like structure, and these are known as dendrites. They are meant for receiving the messages. Messages, or we can say that receiving signals. both are the same thing. And the cytoplasm, which is present in the cytone structure, so there must be some fluid-like substance in every part of the cytone. So this fluid-like substance is known as neuroplasm. So now, after this, we can say that this whole structure is cytone. So first of all, what happened? Let's suppose I am thinking. So the thought will come to the dendrite. It will move through the cytone body and then it will move through axon. Let's see that process also. Let's talk about axon. So here axon is like long branch structure. It is having fat layer. So this one is a fat layer. And after that, in the end, it is having many branches so that it can transport signal to further neurons, or we can say that further cytons. Here, what we need to understand, so where cytone and axon meet, this structure is known as axon Hillock. So we need to understand that this is very sensitive structure. If there is any problem with this structure, or nerves, or we can say neurons will not work. So this broad thing which is going down, it is axon. And here, where fat cells are not there and we can see only axon, this is known as node of Ranvier. So here, this is myelin sheath. Myelin sheath is the layer of fat which provides protection. And here you will see this outer layering, this part. This part is known as neurolemma. Neurolemma means it is a plasma membrane of axon. And here at the terminal, you can see there are many branches. We can say that this is terminal arborization. So now see how our thought moves through the neuron. So let's suppose whenever we are thinking that we will be having some tasty meal. So that thought will move from dendrite, it will move from cytone, nucleus, everything. Then it will move through the axon and through the branches, it will be transferred to another neuron. So that's how this thing works. Now see important highlights about this process. In case of dendrites, they can be one to several in number. Axon, it is only one in number. Here you can spot the difference. So axon is highly important. In case of dendrites, these are comparatively shorter, while axons, these are longest ones, with uniform thickness. That means they are not somewhere thick, somewhere thin. They are having their uniform thickness. So that's about the neuron. So that's how our thinking process, our thought, or everything, whatever we think about, it works like that. I hope you like the content. If you like it, please click on like, comment, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you.